Alrighty then, mic check. Welcome aboard, everybody. It is Sunday night. We've got a week ahead review. We're going to do optimization here tonight. Make sure, if you're not doing so already, follow us over there on Facebook, Twitter, and of course here on YouTube. We've got five categories divided up over there for you. If you have not been part of one of our nighttime broadcasts, tonight is a good night to catch up. Let me turn that music down here just a little bit. So what are we going to do here tonight? We're going to take a look at the week ahead. We're going to look at where the S&P is. We're going to look at the VIX level. We're going to look at earnings reports. And just, you know, we've been in this earnings season here. We've got 2 weeks of earnings that have just kind of gone by here. We've got one more week of big time earnings. Let me know if you guys can hear me all right here. Actually, I didn't put up the live chat here. Hopefully you guys can see me. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now I can see the chat. Test, there we go. All right, so tonight I'm also going to show you guys the optimization process. We're going to walk through it, What is BOW methodology, backtest, optimize, walk forward. I'm going to walk through that here tonight. We do it every Sunday night, of course, and of course during the week, depending on what happens with the VIX, the ATR levels, how much we shift during the week will determine whether or not we redo that again during the week, but always Sunday night, we do just that. All right, so first thing, let's come on down here and take a peek at the NASDAQ week ahead here. We are in the nosebleed section. Actually, let's come take a peek at the ES first. So look at the ES. We are, let's take the biggest time frame here. We are up here on, wow, I mean, just we're hitting the highs. Okay, so tough spot here to play on ES tomorrow. Again, very, very careful. We could drop down and touch that golden rope down below, not too far away here from us. Let's see, am I streaming on? Yeah. We could be pulling all the way back down and touching again and doing some more of this. And then eventually coming up though, 3150 is going to be looking for our first nudging target and a turning point potential at 3100 if we get that continuation follow through. So that is our expectation right now. We've got blue dots on. So long's favorable as we are coming into ES until we get a red. Now, we are sitting in the red. This is why I said this is a little bit difficult because we are technically sitting in a red zone. So we'll zoom in here and look. We have definitely touched it twice, right? So we can come down 100 ticks, easy, right? 89 bar, one single bar here gives us about 100 ticks. And then we can turn right back around and push ourselves back up and just kind of get caught up. Oops. Problem with 4K. I can't really draw too well on this. Yeah, I gotta fix some of this stuff with this 4K drawing, 4K tool. It's still not working right. What's up, Matthias? Thanks for saying hello. So a little bit of trouble we're gonna have here on ES, and NQ is looking a little bit better here for us. We do not have any harmonic formations. The last one we had here was back here, and this thing is obviously broken. We pretty much tapped through it, came through it, and we are moving up, used it for support. We've got blues, blue dot here, biggest potential to push us back up here. But again, right here, we could easily come back down. And remember, that's about 100 ticks. You cannot afford that. So remember, don't play off the 89, the ES. Take this into context as we roll into the week. Hold on. I feel like the sound is a little bit too loud here in my ear. Of course, it's not always on top for some reason. All right, always a few technical difficulties when you move the office around. All right, hopefully you guys can hear me all right. If not, do let me know. Yeah, Matthias, if you can give me a feedback on that, if the sound is okay, we're good there. Okay, so ES, we do have this harmonic reaction right here on a cipher. We had the red dot from before and here. So there could be a potential move down. Actually, I just saw that just now. Again, we'll do analysis in the morning. I'm just seeing what's here tonight as we go into tomorrow and what we're going to run our optimization on. We do have MACV on the red side as well. Yes, we could actually get that shift. But anytime we start to come down like this in this area, when we've got this much momentum to the upside and we've been moving up like crazy on the 89s, tide, wave, ripple, Hard to read here. I'm just going to say, like, this is going to be one of those hard spots in the market there tomorrow. So expect a little bit of some difficulty tomorrow morning. Let's come down here to the NASDAQ. Sound is excellent. Thank you, Matthias. All right. So I like the NASDAQ a lot better here on the 89s. Come on. Doesn't get much easier than this. We've got a sweet, sweet shark showing up here for us. Just, almost a gimme. Man, okay, my drawing tools are just absolutely killing me here on this 4K setup. This is just insane. What is happening to my screens here? Hold on. Oh, I know what I can do. Click here first. Now let's try this. Oh, that's so much better. All right, that was my fault. All right, little rusty. We have not been able to stream for a while. Those of you guys knowing the drama going on with the drama mamas out there on the Twitter shitter. Okay, so look what we've got here. This is so tasty. Oh my word, if we could have anybody catch this today at the open today. We've got, oh, I did it again. I did the drawing thing. Here we go. Inside here, you can't see it here. I'm going to push it out here in just a second. But we've got a pink dot right here. We've got salmon dot, salmon power. We've got two finger salute down. We've got the back of the shark. We got a shark back here. What a powerful location here for the pull down. That is a 100 tick drop right there. Doesn't look like much, but that's why we use the 89 to get this beautiful, beautiful setup there on that harmonic move. Oh, gorgeous. Perfect. Okay. So I have not taken that here. We're just now looking at things, but beautiful setup there. We'll look to see how the overnight works, but this looks like we're coming all the way down to the golden ropes there on NQ. Once we get there though, it's going to be tough pickings, tough spot once we get to that location, but that's our default there. Follow MACV. As soon as the MACV shifts green though, game over. All right, so as this rides, go ahead and ride it down. But if we get a green here, hold up. Okay, wishbone play coming in right here on NQ. Again, this is overnight stuff. If it's not moving, don't trade it. Wait till the morning. Right now, things look very, very still. And we're going to talk about what's coming in on the news this week. Again, very much a dead day on Monday, but we've got news picking up later in the week. So we should see a typical slow Monday. And then we'll roll forward. Let's see on the YM if there's anything. Yeesh. Yuck. Okay. On the Dow. Dow is just sitting inside the golden ropes. Now, this can still be good though, right? If we continue with this zone, all we're gonna be doing. Oh, I just did the drawing thing again. All right, here we go. A little out of practice. Here we go. So we got VL 1, 2, and three shots at this to reverse this back up. Okay, remember this is the wave. Okay, so this is going to be 20 to 40 ticks on the move up, and target one to the golden ropes. If we break through the golden ropes, big targets up here at VL 1 and 2, and that's going to be around 60 or 70 ticks up on the high side on the Dow. Okay, and again, tide still rising, right? Look at where we are on the tide. We are still up here, top golden rope here on the 89s. Whoops, I'm drawing on another screen that you guys can't see. Probably helps if I bring that over. On the 89s, okay? So when we're looking at the big picture, we still have rising tide. We still have the last thing. We got a green touch, okay? So we are still looking for the long side. So as this comes down into this area, we're gonna be looking for our setups for the entries anywhere here in the VL1, VL2, or VL3 locations. Again, first one's gonna be VL1. Biggest touch is gonna be off of this location if we're gonna get up for the big one. If we get to the second one though, remember, we're gonna be hitting just into the golden ropes. Okay, you know how the plan works. All right, 89s, putting that back. Put those back in the right place is probably helpful. All right, so let's take a peek at the news. Here coming into the week, what do we have on the docket? First of all, our VIX. I looked at this earlier. So remember, the sweet spot is 13.14. This is not good. Okay, when we start to drop down this low, what are we looking for? Pushing probes. Okay, look for the pushing probe strategy majority of the time when we are below 13. Okay. And look at the drop. So I put this over, this is a 3 month period. Let's look at the 5 day here. Okay, look, the only day we came up, this is the 25th. Something very odd came in on that Thursday. This was the, remember, big earnings reports day there, but we dropped right back into the steady pace here down around that 12 area, which means, again, we're gonna be looking for the markets to rise. Okay, defaults, longs favorable until otherwise spoken. Okay, remember, we're reacting to what the market's giving us, but we're trying to get a little bit of anticipation for our entries. At the end of the day, all we care about though are those entry setups in the direction of the formations that we have on the big time frames, which we've already identified. All right, next we are looking at the news itself for tomorrow. Forex Factory, let's see what we've got here. Let me zoom this in. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. There we go. Okay, so here, home sales, where's the red? These are tentatives, after hours, and the rest of this is non-US. Again, basically a null day tomorrow, not a whole lot on the docket for tomorrow. Basically clean day, gonna be all technicals as far as we can tell. And again, unless breaking news comes out, of course breaking news breaks things, but as far as what's on the docket right now, what we can see there, looks like pretty much gonna be a slow Monday for that. Let's look at the week in review. For the week, what's coming up ahead besides tomorrow? So we've got personal income layouts. Let's see if we have FOMC. Yes, we have FOMC this week. I kind of thought we did. There it is. So FOMC on Wednesday. Again, on a FOMC week plus earnings. We're going to talk about this. This is going to be one of those super FOMC days. Okay. So we've got FOMC plus earnings reports on that Wednesday, plus crude oil inventories. So Wednesday is gonna be a big pick-me-up. So expect tomorrow just some slow choppiness. Let's go with the trend, but look for the reversal on the south side. If we get to the south of any of that, look for the push back up and kind of hover into those golden ropes, especially on Tuesday, right? This is gonna be ropes day. Tuesday, everything toward those ropes prior to 2 p.m., right? 2 p.m. is our standard FOMC. If you don't know about the FOMC rules, go check out my FOMC rules videos for information on that. Then we got post FOMC on Thursday, and you guys know what those rules are. And let's look at how many earnings reports. Let's see what's the biggest day for earnings this week, so we know when the big volatility is kicking in. So we've got Monday, 141 companies reporting. Then we've got 258, 311, and of course Thursday, again, biggest day for earnings reports, 338 on Thursday. Big moves, expect them coming in on Thursday, right? If you want to rest up at the beginning of the week, rest up for that Thursday, because Thursday is going to be killer, okay? With follow through on the Friday, and again, early in, early out on a Friday. However, we are going to be testing our stuff here at the end of the day in SIM as we go into the latter half of the day. And of course, we are looking for the next release that's coming out. You guys are going to see some beta releases coming out to you guys. Those of you guys who signed up for beta, if you want to check out the new release, you want to check out the new features, there is a video on there. Look up the chart cast and new features for AlgoBox. Those are going to be coming out this week as well. For those of you guys who signed up for beta for us, good stuff. All right, so I'm going to put this up here. Now then, let's talk about optimizations. If you've never been in here for an optimization, I'm going to walk through what optimization is. I'm not actually going to run through one here specifically and show the actual run through. I'm going to do that here in a few minutes, and I'll post that into Discord. If you haven't been in Discord already, if you're wondering where that's going to show up, let's bring over Discord here. So this is our Discord trade room. If you guys have not been in here, again, this is open 24 hours for free, open into the public section. We will post the optimized ranges here for the week as we post those in. Again, we are going to explain what that is and how that works, but those will be posted in here. It will look like a grid. If you are ever looking for the permanent location for those, head on over. Those of you guys who are in premium, that will be posted over in this area, and this is what that looks like. So as we zoom in on one of these, this is going to tell you every instrument that we trade. Again, some of you guys who, you know, trade other things, This is the list. If you want to know what that period is, again, this is when we're using range charts, particularly for some of our strategies. Really, it's the mid time frame that we should be looking for. And of course, really great for two finger salutes is the ideal for this one right here. And of course, that double dot hitting off of these is going to be your biggest moves when one of these periods occurs. All right. Also take a peek at this column right here, average time in market. Again, you guys who like the slow stuff, okay, you're going to be looking at the time in market, right? Here's ES, still choking at 111 minutes per trade. That's a pretty long time, in my opinion. I really like the 20 to 40 minute trade. So what am I going to be looking for? I'm going to be looking for the Dow, RTY, NQ, still down here at 9 minutes. That's a real good one, real fast here on NQ, liking some of that. CL's getting close to being a little bit too slow at 32 minutes. I'm going to kind of pass on that. Same thing with gold. Okay, gold at 32 minutes, a little bit too long for me. 20 to 40 minutes, yes, it's still in there. It's playable. However, I'm going to probably pass on those. So which ones am I going to choose? I choose it by the time frames. These are also out of bounds here. 6J at 36, and of course 6E, super slow there at 81 minutes for the average for what we're looking for targets. Okay. All right, if you guys got questions on that, pop those over in the chat box. I'm going to get into the details of how we actually optimize. What is optimization? If you've never done algorithmic trading, again, most of you guys have heard about backtest. That, unfortunately, when I teach you guys this stuff, you know, I just don't think people understand. And this is a very big misconception when it comes to algorithmic trading. You know, everybody knows backtest, right? So they think that, wow, I can't draw here tonight. we're just gonna type it out. So backtesting is what everybody hears. Everybody talks about this. They're like, well, my backtest, you know, this thing looked great. You know, my backtest results, you know, were great. Are those useful? Well, that's the very first start. The problem with most people is they stop right here, okay? Backtest, and then they look at it and they're like, okay, cool, and they go to run. They're missing out on three additional pieces. All right, so what do we do in Vinny's methodology here? We do the BOW methodology. Okay, so what is BOW? B.O.W. Okay, and optional Monte Carlo. All right, if you want to get on the MC. Monte Carlo. However, this is when you are first testing out your strategy. You've got to make sure that you're not just doing, you've got something that's dependent upon a black swan. And of course, it's built in a NinjaTrader for us, and we use that inside of AlgoBox to determine our ranges on a daily basis. One of the advantages and the edges that we have when we post out our optimized ranges and everybody's hitting those, it's a trick like where everybody is trying to figure out that that a lot of strategies work on all time frames, but what time frame is in play? That's most people's problem, is if you could only know which time frame was in play, you would do so much better. And that's actually what we do, and we let the algorithmic tools tell us what those are in our optimization process. So what do I mean by the optimization process? So that is the O in the BOW. Of course, B is backtest, O, optimize, W. This is another one. I mean, so some people like get to part one and part two, maybe they kind of got this, but this is where pretty much everybody just gets completely lost, has no idea what they're doing with this, and this is walk forward. I also do the W for a window. This is a sliding window test that must be run for your strategy to make sure you've got the optimized settings for the current market conditions. Because again, the problem with backtest is that it's only as good as the data that it's been run on. It's got to be shown that it has an edge moving forward, which is what optimization and walk forward are absolute must-haves in order to do that, in my opinion. Now, again, you guys can argue with me about it, put it down in the comments down below if you've got some thoughts on that. But without optimization and walk forward, you really do not have anything, and you should not be trading that, especially using algorithmic styles where you're just going to let it go full auto. Absolutely not. Okay. Monte Carlo is really a test on a black swan. I won't get into that here tonight. So how do we do that? What is the optimization process? So it's been a while. Let's go ahead and draw one of these up. I think some people have been here for so long since we pulled one of these out that some of you guys, I think even the people who've been around a while, may not have seen this. Let's see, I haven't drawn this on a 4K monitor, and now we go on 4K, and I can tell everything is dragging a little bit here on me. All right, so let's pretend that this is time. Now, if I can, if I had done this properly, I would have had another line in here. All right, so our job when, let's do another one line right here. Our job during our optimization process is literally to predict the future. This is the closest thing to a crystal ball you are ever gonna get, in my opinion. Now again, I'd love to hear some comments down below if you guys, if you have some other thoughts on that, but here's what I'm gonna tell you. All right, here we go. Optimization, period. And this is technically called your walk period, but I don't like to walk too much, so I like to call it the run period, but that whole walk forward thing is where that comes from. So this is the walk forward period over here in this section. Now, what is the optimization period? So what we want to do is pretend like this box over here represents tomorrow morning. Okay, now again, technically it's after midnight, of course, depending on what part of the world you're in, but we're talking everything about in Eastern time here. So today in the morning here, what we want to know is, but let's pretend like we did this yesterday, okay? What we want to do is we want to predict the future. So how on earth can I predict the future, right? Wouldn't it be awesome if I had a time machine and I could go over here and predict what tomorrow looked like, right? It would. Now, let's draw this up, okay? So we know what last week looked like, okay? Let's pretend like this period back here represents the last 2 weeks, okay? And we saw the market do this, and now we are right here, okay? So at this spot right here, this is where the market closed on Friday, okay? Because tonight is Sunday, this is what the market looked like. Now, wouldn't it be amazing if you could tell that tomorrow, that the ES, for instance, let's talk about the S&P 500. Let's say that you could predict that the S&P 500 tomorrow is gonna go up to 3,100, come down to 28, fake up, fake down, and then end up like this. Now, wouldn't that be awesome if you could predict that? Yeah? So what we're trying to do is do exactly that, okay? Now, what is this based upon? You have to understand that in optimization and walk forward, you have to have some assumptions. This assumption is that what has happened in the recent past is likely to happen into the near future, that we are going to have a continuation of what the current market structure is, that we're not just going to go crazy out of bounds. Now, yes, a black swan event could occur at any time, but what we want to do is get our best guess for tomorrow, okay? So again, this is never, nothing about this is 100%. You're not ever going to just absolutely be able to, use the back data that you have and do a perfect curve fit and then be able to predict exactly what this is looking like. But we can get a pretty close representation of what this might be, right? Unless it's just one of those outlandish days. Now, again, things like breaking news breaks things. If we've got FOMC, events like that, though, that's why we care about where those news events occur. But in general, we're looking for a day like tomorrow, Monday, where it's all technicals. And this is one of our areas where we really have the maximized potential on our Monday and Tuesday runs. So why we put these out on Sunday. And we look to see how that Monday, Tuesday ran and whether or not we're going to rerun that on Wednesday or not depends on how close we were on Monday and Tuesday, okay? Now, again, everything is about risk control. In between that, in the event that, yes, the black swan event occurs, that's what your risk management is there for. And, of course, for us, we're only risking our capital for 90 minutes per session. We only trade for 90 minutes in the morning session or in the afternoon session. Of course, depending on, we got a lot of people from Australia, so it's like nighttime their time. But you know what I mean. Everything we talk about here is in Eastern Standard Time, okay? So you guys get the point that we want to predict the future. We want to predict this box right over here. So here's what we do. Here's how this works. Optimization period. Now, the optimization period, the question is, and here's where the proprietary stuff comes in, right? I don't necessarily teach how and what I do with this unless you guys are in the platinum group. And again, there are NDAs on that and you guys understand that. And of course, I do teach very thorough on how and why and what based on my own market experience of 11 years now that I've been in it and doing it. However, optimization, what do? We're gonna let the bots do what the bots do best, okay? They are going to take this entire set of optimization period and it is just going to obliterate this and it's going to chop it up. Let's see, let's pick a nice color here. How about some, well, green's gonna be all, now let's go back to our orange. Okay, so what this is gonna do is this is gonna chop up the market into segments all over the place and this is going to test based on, now again, I've got to pre-code this, but based on my strategies that I have already backtested and found that I have edge, now I want to optimize those based on those strategies and the optimized periods, and I'm sorry, and on those parameters. I want to know what are the best parameters for my strategy for tomorrow, right? That's the very simplest question that we're trying to answer is, what are the settings that are going to be best for tomorrow, okay? And that was that grid that I kicked out earlier that I showed you guys how and what that looks like, right? But here's how it works. If you are kind of geeked out and you want to find out what we do with this, so here's how this works. What the bot does is it tests all these different parameters and it runs this over and over and over and over again in a series, okay? So it runs this data over and over and over, and it does it on multiple markets. That's the other beautiful thing about what our process and our system does, is that we kick back and let it give us the information for all of our markets. We let the bots do what the bots do best, and then we take the human element, sort of that cyborg mentality of molding computers with humans and letting the computer do what it does best, and the humans do what we do best when we execute on those strategies, okay? So this runs over and over again, and then it kicks out that grid of data that says, okay, what I did based on my information, I found that I was able to get this, we had a winner that was from here to here, perfect trade, and then we got from here to here was a perfect trade, and here to here we got this great trade. And again, like, this tried this all different ways and it had tons and tons of ways, but what it found was during this curve, and this is where the word curve fit comes from. I'm sure you guys who have been around algorithmic trading have heard that term, curve fitting. So in the curve of the price action that we have, the optimizer has found that in this curvature that the best optimized parameters for the last X period, okay, were blank. Now again, for one market, it's going to be one row. Okay, so we get the parameters listed for one market, like let's say that this was the ES. Okay, but then what I've got in my grid is I've got all those parameters kicked out for all markets. Okay, so that's what the whole grid was. So all each of the markets that we are running through, again, that's what that whole grid is that I just showed you guys. And then of course that's available over there in Discord if you guys are interested in testing that out and checking it out. Of course, you can always download our entire AlgoBox suite, try it out for yourself, 2 weeks. Again, no strings attached, just, you know, it's yours, try it out. If you like it, great. If you can't figure it out, don't understand it, you might want to come in the room and ask us questions and things. But again, we know that we're so confident in our tools, you can put them on your machine and, you know, you'll see the difference on what we do, okay? So optimization period, this is what this is. So during this optimization, what's up, Ronnie? Hi, Fox. Fox News? What, we only tell the truth around here? That's true. I like that. Okay. All right. So here's what we got. In this zone, what we want, we know now that this is what we're going to run for tomorrow. Okay. Now, what we have predicted, what this has predicted, is that price is going to continue. And let's change the color here. We have predicted that the price will do something like this. Okay. The robot has literally said, okay, based on this previous curvature, based on what we've got here, same ATR ranges, it's probably going to look something like this. Now, it's pretty good at doing this, right? It's not going to go, oh, okay, tomorrow the market is probably going to look like this, right? That there's an obvious difference between that and this. So what it's going to do is it's going to present a curve that is predictably what should be approximately the same as that. What's up, Simon? How you doing, my friend? So this is how this works, and we're going to take our settings here that we got based on the previous optimization period, and we're going to run this forward for tomorrow. That is the optimization process. So that's it in a nutshell and me explaining it, and it's a very complicated process, but I have tried to break it down as simply as I can. So I hope you guys understand that. If you guys have questions on it, pop those over in the chat box. Maybe I missed something on that highlight reel there. Again, we're just kind of doing this on the fly, doing this live as usual. But if you have questions, we are here to answer them. All right. So speaking of that optimization and getting out that grid here, what I'm going to do is go run that right now. And again, it takes, depending on how much data and how far back we're going, I'm going to look to find out what that's going to be here. But this can take anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes for our process. on a pretty beefy machine to process all 8 markets that we are trading. So I'll kick those out and post those over in Discord here shortly. So make sure if you guys are hanging out here with us and you want to get those set up on your charts here tomorrow, so head on over there to Discord and set up your charts before you get trading there tomorrow morning, especially those of you guys who are hanging out with us in the crew. All right, folks, that's it. Make sure if you haven't done so already, smash that like button, subscribe if you want to get those notifications when we go live. Of course, follow us over there on Facebook, Twitter, and of course here on YouTube. And I will catch you guys in the morning, and I will put out that optimization grid here in just about 30 minutes over there in Discord. Thanks for hanging out, folks. I'm going to send it off right here for me, Pippi, Robbie, Lunchbot, Mod Squad, Curtis G, and of course, we got Simon, the man, the myth, the legend himself with us here tonight. I'm sending out that big H down. See ya.
Stumble, left him covered in a big pot of gumbo. I guess, in a way, being gracious is my weakness. People say I'm so unpretentious for a genius.
I've got it all, and I'm getting more, but I never thought I'd be the mall, cause you know I'm so humble.
I say that with no ego. It's just good manners.
You say I'm a 10, but I'm a needy best. Plus two says you, not me. I'm so humble.
Mama raised me right.
To get off the darkest ground, but gravity pulls you straight down. Earth from a bird's eye view, you should grow feathers and see this too. When you want to get off the